At your leisure.
Ready? Okay. Hello.
Hi.
How are you? You're here for our meeting?
Up there, unsafe travel update, so.
Oh, okay, just have a seat and we'll be ready shortly. Okay, I'd like to call to order the October 20th meeting of the Barnstable County Commissioners and ask you to join us in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now we will have a moment of silence to remember our American troops who are serving here as well as in the two wars overseas and those who have given their lives for this country. Thank you. We can do this first.
Public comment?
Yeah, under public comment. If you would like to identify yourselves and tell us why you're here.
We need to stand up.
Yeah. Well, you don't have to stand up. You can sit.
Sounds great.
Okay.
My name is Margaret Song, and I'm the Residential Program Manager for the Cape Light Compact. Mm-hmm.
And I'm Brianna King, Residential Program Coordinator for the Cape Light Compact.
Okay.
We recently went to Denver, Colorado. Thank you for the approval to go. For the Energy Star partner meeting, it was actually a combined meeting, a little bit different from in years past, that combined efficient lighting, appliances, electronics, and water heaters. And as I am transitioning some of these duties to Brianna, I was able to introduce her to some of the market players, some of the representatives that we've been working on, as well as continue some of the programs.
This was a wonderful experience for me to meet certain companies, form relationships that you normally don't get to form in this type of environment, and really get a better handle on the programs and how they operate to move these programs to our larger goals for 2011.
Yeah.
When I used to go to Denver, I was always struck at how concerned they were, you know, the people who lived there, in a much more active way about things that were happening around them. The whole Front Range area from Denver up to Fort Collins was it's a desert, you know. So one of the concerns that they have was conservation, and the weather was usually wonderful in the wintertime. It would snow one day, and then the next day the sun would come up. You'd think it was springtime. So, and it was there was a restaurant there that I went to that used to serve bear meat.
Oh. We didn't encounter that.
You didn't get that.
I wouldn't put it past Denver. They are very concerned with their natural environment, which I think is really admirable. You know, a lot of people are very outdoorsy there, and they live off the land, so I think it's great.
Can we have one more question?
Mm-hmm.
I always ask
that
this.
Wasn't a question.
That was sharing with you. My very pleasant
right.
experience out there. What do you think your main takeaway was at the conference?
For me, really, it was the relationships that I was able to develop. And now I can reach out, ask, you know, where you're going to be with this program in 2011. We want to get on board now, able to sign things. So that was the best thing for me, to actually be able to get the face-to-face with these companies and even people that work on other efficiency programs throughout the country to learn what they're doing in an environment where you don't normally get to that on a nationwide call.
Yeah, and I think the important thing to always remember is that these programs are voluntary for businesses, retailers, manufacturers. So they're sort of doing this for other reasons. And sometimes when our small little state, even though we're number two now in the nation for energy efficiency, which is great, we ask for certain things. And because of some of our data requirements, there are questions about why we need to do that. Some of the explanations in person, I think, are a little bit more palatable and understandable, because someone from, 3,000 miles away, it can be difficult to have that conversation. So the meetings are always good, and I'm glad Brianna will go to them in the future.
Just one final question. Between now and March, I want you to think about the issues that, you know, that you've thought about, because when I go to the legislative conference, I sit on the committee for environment, energy, and land use. So I would be very interested in any, you know, in anything that appears to be burning issues, from the context that you made, because when we go to NACO, we do identify the issues that could become resolutions that would be supported in the by the lobbying organization that's part of that. So it's all part of how we move this whole process forward. You may recall that the CDBG grants came about with support from part of the things that were going on in NACO, and I'm hoping that if other opportunities come up, if we know what to push for, then I'll make sure that voice is heard.
Now, are these national companies, I would assume, that are there, who manufacture some of the materials and equipment that you use in the energy efficiency programs? Is that how that works?
There are companies there to represent products, to move technology forward, but as well as consultants mm-hmm. that would help facilitate advancing mm-hmm. energy efficiency as well. So the DOE was there, the EPA was there, representatives.
People from the state?
People
from the state office of?
No.
No, just mostly federal.
Yes.
Okay.
We did not, but other states did have state representatives, and the companies that you're talking about are some of the big retailers, the big manufacturers, but there were also representatives from local buying groups as well. So nationwide, which sometimes you'll see on the side of the buses as you're going by Key Boston, you'll see that. So some of our local retailers do buy from those folks. They are trying to aggregate this to make it a little bit easier on the local businessman or woman who has to deal with some of the marketing and some of the ways to deal with all of these programs everywhere. So it was both.
So you come back all energized with new ideas and ready to go, huh?
Yes,
that's
absolutely.
Great.
Trying to
Good.
Set up some meetings right now as we speak. So
okay.
Super. I think that would be something that should sort of drop us a note and let us know how that progress is. I think energy efficiency and energy conservation has probably been the most, say, persistent contribution that we've made to reducing the cost for people in Barnstable County. And now that you have more opportunity to move in that direction, keep us advised so we can make sure that people know that we're trying to help them as much as possible.
Good. Okay. Well, thanks very much for coming
in.
We really appreciate this. This is important to us to know that you're out there meeting people and what you're learning and how you can use that in your work. So thanks very much for coming.
Thank you.
Bye.
I have something.
Yes.
Don't go. Margaret Dust was a presenter at a national conference a few months ago.
I was,
and
yes.
I wonder if you might consider doing a presentation for this group and through this group to the people of Cape Cod.
What do you think, Maggie? I think it's a great idea.
And perhaps you could put it over the assembly, because at the assembly, their usual interest is...
I think the level at the assembly level would be too specific. Mm. They a better presentation on the programs in general. Margaret's presentation was very specific on lighting. That's the Chicago conference, I'm assuming. We speak at many conferences all the time, so I'm not really sure which one, if you're referring to...
I think it was Washington, D.C., but I'm not positive.
It was
Pennsylvania,
actually. So it was near that area.
It was. And what was the topic that you were talking about?
I was representing residential energy efficiency programs and their focus on LEDs. Yep. So because we've been very vocal for Little Cape Cod and Little Martha's Vineyard, we've been very vocal on that front. But I'm also giving a presentation soon. Which you guys have just also pre-approved, where I'm speaking on advancing high-performance building for residential folks in Chicago.
Well, I would suggest maybe that you talk with Maggie and see.
We never scheduled the Cape Light Compact presentation. Remember, we were going to go
right.
back in front of the commissioners.
Right.
So we have to just, I think, talk with the chair as to how level do you want to. This is like a slice of one program,
mm-hmm.
or do we want to hire level program for the audience, so I'll talk to you about it.
Okay, so and then we'll work something, Maggie will work something out with you.
I think that sounds great.
Good. I think it does too. Thanks very much.
Have a good one.
Thank you, Steve. Okay, next we're going to, you have a, or Maggie has a copy of a memo. On the next discussion, you don't have a copy of your agenda?
No.
The agenda item is a discussion on the request for quotes for the assessment of county services. Prior to proceeding with...
Excuse me, have we finished with public comment?
Yeah, yeah. There's nobody else here.
Okay.
Now we're moving to our next item, was a discussion of the request that the commissioners made for quotes for assessment of county services. And Maggie is in charge of this project at this stage and has provided some information to us for our review before she actually makes the contacts to various companies. We have to know exactly what we're doing on paper and agree to it so that that same information then is part of the RFQ. So you want
to... seems to me I just gave you all of my copies.
Here. Well, I have another one.
So I just want to make sure that you review it and are in make any edits or in agreement with what we you have tasked and you're looking for quotes on.
Okay.
I can I can read it for those at home. The county commissioners seek to hire a consultant who will prepare a report assessing the current state of county services. Commissioners believe that in order to complete this report, the following tasks should be accomplished. Review of the county's annual budget, the annual report, last county services report, interview department heads, number two, as to what services are provided by the department, who their customers are, who's being served, internal or external, number of employees in the department, total of department budget, and then ask department head services that they would like to expand, add new services, or delete, and then that all of that information would be compiled in a report to you, including some recommendations. You'd be able to know this is what the services are right now, this is what it costs, this is who's being served, and that you would also, the consultant would provide recommendations on any organizational recommended changes that they've discovered as part of this process, and then you would use that for your next step, which is phase two, which are consideration of any changes that you wish to make.
So this is basically the outline of the RFP or the RF.
It's not, it's a request for quotes.
Quotes.
But you have
RFQ.
To give everybody, tell
same
everybody
same
what
thing.
You're asking for them, otherwise you won't be able to compare prices. So, and I want to make sure that the three of you agree on what it is that you're asking the consultant to do.
There's one more thing I think I would add to number two in terms of the department heads. Mm-hmm. How long has the service been provided?
Yes.
Less than 5 years, you know, more than 10 years, something like that.
And also, how did it originate? Did it originate through a grant and then it became part of the county's responsibility?
Like AmeriCorps originated as a grant
as
and
a grant.
Became a responsibility mm-hmm. kind of
grant. Right, that we've taken on. But some of those we are doing and we're like, well, why are we still doing, you know, mm-hmm. we might be thinking,
okay.
why are we still
now
doing
that's
that?
That's good.
All right.
And then the last paragraph, in terms of outcomes. The final report would identify county services provided and to whom and the cost of providing these services. The report would also include recommendations on possible revisions to the county's organizational structure that would improve operations, potentially reduce costs, and improve services. The final report would identify county services and the cost of providing these services.
Mm-hmm. I would not to add to this, but I think that I would like to suggest that we have a mindset that thinks about what we believe, regardless of what we're doing, but what we believe the county's role and responsibility with regard to services. Mm-hmm. What do we see for that? Because I think that that would inform the evaluation that we receive.
Right. Well, this I think this report will provide us with the data that we need
to have that discussion.
Based on this, what services do we believe the county should continue?
Well, I guess I'm going beyond that. This is a not an obituary, mm-hmm. but basically an evaluation of where we are.
Right.
Okay. I don't think that we should rely upon a consultant to tell us where we should go.
Oh, no.
No, that's
our job.
That's right.
Absolutely.
That's all right.
That's why we make sure
they can make recommendations
to us. This is just to see where we are.
Mm-hmm. maybe, about...
And also in the cost of those services, there's revenue.
But not to tell us where to go from here. But they might make some recommendations, organizational...
And I certainly hear that, but I wouldn't want the people to think that we, you know, that we are not, you know, do not possess some sense of where, a vision as to what we think would be, you know, would be sort of...
Well, this is helping us with that, though, right.
So is everyone okay with this?
I'm fine with it.
You're fine with it? You're fine with it? I'm fine with it.
I have someone that I want, that is interested in this.
Well, let Maggie know so she can, yeah.
I need, if you have, as I'm contacting, I'll need person's name and contact information so that I can reach out. And my goal is to have Elaine work on this so that the week after next you'll have a report, which would be the 3rd of November.
I need to make copies of something before we proceed to the next...
Next item?
And we're into 40 seconds.
Well, wait a minute, let's just, all right, so we don't need a vote on this, but we need consensus that this is where we want to go.
I've got your edits, thank you very much, and I will come back to you. Hopefully, it's going to give them time to put something together. So I'll come back to you next week and tell you where we are, and, you know, I'll get something in from everybody by a date certain.
Good. Okay, now, we can... let's have a vote on the summary of actions.
I have a question on number 9.
Sure.
You're not Mags at Cape Cod.
Why?
No.
What?
My old email.
To amend the vote of January 14th. Oh, this is from the EDC.
Oh, I see.
What they did is that there was an error in the terms somehow, and they had too many people whose terms expired at one time, mm-hmm. so they wanted to change it so that the terms were more evenly spaced. That's what it is.
Okay, and that also applies to number 10 as well, I guess.
Yep.
Exactly.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, G. Thomas Ryan as the coordinator. That's the Human Rights Commission is asking for approval of this.
Yeah, I wondered about that too. To a bid for a contractor for a coordinator. Is this somebody is number 19.
We have done this before, but the main issue is to make sure that that when the Human Rights Commission hires somebody, that it's not he's not identified as being an employee.
Mm-hmm. That's correct, because they're not.
Right. So this is a contract.
So this is a contract to someone to work with them.
Yes.
Right.
Okay. Okay. Any other questions? Hearing none. A motion to approve.
I'll move to approve the summary of items.
Any second.
Second. No further discussion. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed. None opposed. None we opposed. Have favor. Motion carries.
I have one other vote, if I may, since your arm seconded.
Yeah.
There seems to be, on our vacation carryover that we did, I think the one we did in June, Robert, they can't place the vote, so I'd like you to approve, and I'll pass this out, the vacation carryover request as submitted by employees to be all carryover to be used unless otherwise specified by 12/31/10. And here's the list of the employees. I thought we did this already, but Robin can't put her finger on it, the vote, so I just want to make sure that the record is complete.
Okay.
So if somebody would move to approve the vacation carryover request of Tech for County employees as listed on Robin Sextonisis's 7/4/10 memo, all carryover time to be used by 12/31/10.
I'll move.
Second.
Thank you.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? None opposed? 3 in favor. Motion carries.
Thank you.
I just sent that to you. Hopefully it opens up for you.
Okay. So you want to do something before we go into executive session?
I want to make a couple of copies.
Well, we could
of
actually vote to go into executive session.
And I can just make those
now, copies. And then you could go and make them, and then we wouldn't tie up Steve.
Okay.
So I will entertain a motion to go into executive session and return to public session in a recess until we meet with the assembly at 4 o'clock. For personnel matters under Mass General Law, Chapter 66, Section 10.